this in our goals of 2015 and 2016, with the viability of Lowndes County looking at plan review, permitting, inspections for the unincorporated areas of Lowndes County. You provided us with some information. You want to share that with us?
Yes, sir. The first thing staff done was develop what would be needed as far as employees and amenities to start as the department, such as inspection and planning. Employees, a minimum of 6 with the department manager, 2 department clerks, which also shares admin duties, 3 inspectors, which is certified in all areas of inspection, which is building, mechanical, electrical, plumbing, as well as energy and sprinklers, all that. 4 vehicles, 1 for each inspector, and then 1 department vehicle for the managing clerks. All the IT needs, 6 computers or laptops, permit and inspection software, printers, fax machines, phones, cell phones. A location, that's one other thing that would be needed. We estimate 1,500 square feet. Be a lobby, permit clerk, admin space, department manager office, a plan review area, which could also house the inspector's offices, copy room, storage room, and file room. All the furniture and amenities to go along with those, that area. You see the desk and plan review tables, chairs. And then administratively, we would have to develop policies and procedures, ordinances, resolutions, and also who would take care of marshalling. Could it be done with current code enforcement officers, or would we need an additional marshal that we can look at these items? From there, we took and developed an annual budget. And these are numbers that we went to each department based on current communities of our size, especially on the personnel end. We had Mr. Bills go in and put in all the wages and the benefits to come up with a number for the personnel, the vehicles, advertising, all the way down for a total of $430,257.23 for annual budget. For the unincorporated Lowndes County area only, in 2015, the permit cost totaled $495,028, and the plan review total came to $9,475.25 for a total revenue of $504,503.25. Then we started looking at what other items would have to be purchased year one to get started. And it's $40,000 in IT, which is mainly software. We have a good bit of the software heating, but we would have to purchase an additional standalone software that came in just under $40,000. Vehicles, $84,000, and furniture, $15,000, and then any cost for space build out, which year one additional cost would be $139,000 plus any additional space.
That includes the drive through, the contractor, the
permit, the drive. Have it possibly online processing system.
What we staff developed as far as what it would take to get a department started. We looked at that is actual revenue for 2015, just for unincorporated lines.
Chairman, that number's a lot better than I expected.
Absolutely. And I can tell you from
from our standpoint, 2016, we've seen a, it's been, or 2017 has been an increase from 15 and 16. So we're seeing more permits, more plan review, more houses being built than, you know, than we've seen in any of the previous years. So I mean, it's continuing to get better.
I wouldn't be even taking into consideration, I'm going to get a little more efficient. I'm not saying it's lost people, you know, any of that, but if you incorporate planning and zoning, and those are kind of combined somewhat into one, you probably think that's what's happening to that.
Okay. Great information. That's just what we need. Just to start some discussions and move forward. Again, the wrong people are here, but we're all here to talk about it.
Anything else you guys got?
Yes, sir.
Mike will be back tomorrow to speak about transportation. So,
that's a great deal.
Check.
Thank you.